In this section, guys, we're going to focus on the brute force algorithm to find the convex hull of a bunch of points. The brute force algorithm is not the efficient one. There are many other algorithms more efficient than the brute force, like the gift wrapping, aka Jarvis Marsh, Graham's Can algorithm, quick hold, divide and conquer algorithm, etc. Let's come back to our brute force algorithm and how it works. First, every time we're gonna pick 2 points, not every time, here we're gonna pick 2 points. Let's say these 2 points, for example, point 3 and point 4, and draw a line here. And we have to check if all the other points are in one side or of the line. For example, here all the other points are not on just one side of the line. If we continue the line here like this and not like this, as you see, not all the points are on one side of the line. But for example, if we take these 2 points, 1 and 2, point 1 and point 2, as you see, all the other points, the rest of points, are only on one side of the line, or these points 2 and 9, for example. Here, in this case, we can say that the 2 points 2 and 9 form a part of the convex hull. Same for the point 1 and 2. How to know 2 points or the other points are on one side of the line or not? By computing the convex hull of all the rest of points with respect of the line 2, 9 here. Of course, if you don't know what's the orientation or the cross product, you can see the part one. I explain this. Let's say that we want to move from 2 to 9. We can compute the cross product. We can check the orientation of all the rest of points by drawing a vector here. Sorry for this. I prefer this one. Drawing a vector here. A vector u, for example. And a vector v, and we have to check the cross product u times v, not v times u, as we have said in the rotation part. If we apply the trick or the right hand rule here, we put the index and the vector u, the middle finger on the vector v, your thumb will be up, then we can say that this cross product is positive. If we do the same for all the rest of points, we will find the same cross product, the same sign, the same sign which is positive for all this product. And this time we can say that all these points are on one side of the line. If we take two other points here, let's say these points, point 3 and point 11, we put this here and this here. The cross product from this side is positive, index finger, middle finger, for every point here is positive. However, the cross product or the rotation of these point with respect of 3, 11 is negative. We can check it. If we take 8, this is the index, this is the middle finger. If you put your index in the index finger and the index vector, and the middle, your thumb will be down. So we can say the cross product is negative on this part. We can conclude here, not all the rest of points are on once on one side of the line, are on the both side here. The time complexity of this algorithm is O, big O n square, for the picking the two points. Every time we're going to pick 1, 2, then 1, 3, then 1, 4, then 1, 6, etc., 1, 5, 1, 6, etc., then 2, 3, 2, 4. We have checked all the two points. For each pair of points, we have to check if it is on this side or the other side of the picked two points. The total time complexity is big O n cube. Is not efficient as you see. Now, how to know if all the rest of points are on one side or not? Let's say x is the number of the point that have the cross product positive, and y the number of the points that have the cross product null. Every time when we find a point that its cross product with respect of that line of this picked two points is positive, we add 1 to x. For example, when we find the cross product positive, if you find the cross product negative, we reduce 1 from x. If you find it, if the cross product is null, we just add 1 to y. How to find if all the points are on side or the other side? If and only if we have this Boolean expression return true, which is x plus y is equal to n minus 2, or x minus y is equal to minus n minus 2. If all the points, the cross product of all the points is positive, we can find x is equal to n minus 2, y is 0. If, for example, we have 5 points and 2 points where the cross product is null, and 3 points where the cross product is positive, this is n minus 2, of course, 5. We have picked 2 points, then the total number of points is 7 here. We pick 2 points from 7. The rest of points is 5. So 2 plus 3 is 5, which is the rest of point. Then we can say all the rest of points is with respect of these 2 points is on one side. This formula gives us the result when the cross product is negative. Let's say this case, for example, here. If we pick these 2 points, and we move like this, all the cross product for this all points is negative. So x will be minus 5 here, which is equal to minus 5. 5 comes from 7 here, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 minus 2 is 5. The rest of the point is 5. That's why we reduce 1 from x. This is a very quick explanation of the brute force algorithm. In next part, we're going to practice on a lead code problem.